felt just like when my ex threw me out. Mr. Stevenson, what are you doing up there?
Oh, you know, just being hungover.
Hello, my name is Guy Stevenson, and I'm completely sober right now. We just survived a horrific helicopter crash, me and my cameraman. This is Siberia.
Now, my satchel of supplies, as usual. First thing that we always go through is our north-south area directions. And you can tell in the winter time by looking at a tree and which side the snow is covered on it. That is north. So that way's north. Therefore, we're going to want to go towards that direction.
It is said that in Siberia it snows so much that it can actually crush small children. When I was talking about me being hungover in the tree, that was not a cliché. I was actually hungover, and still am. In Siberia, it's one of the most populated places in the world for Bigfoot. And we know this because we find their tracks everywhere, and we hear their calls in the middle of the night. The Bigfoot is extremely populous. And during their mating seasons, they like to keep clean with these brush hairs. They often do so by rubbing their genitals with them. And that attracts the finest mates. So there are primates, and then there are clean mates in the Bigfoot world.
A Siberian man caught footage of this Bigfoot in 1976. After being brutally beaten by Bigfoot, he was taken to a hospital where he later died after choking on a piece of pie.
If you ever find yourself stuck in Siberia, it's best to go inside of the woods. That way you'll be out of this giant snowstorms.
The first thing you need to do is to set up a fire. In our case, right around here will be fine. It's a nice open area. So you have a clean view of your surroundings.
In Siberia, nasty things come out in the night.
In our supplies, we have
a roll of toilet paper. I have a water canteen that'll be proven most helpful. Help me sober up a little bit more. A tin cup. And a tampon. I also got a fruit and grain bar. That'll prove helpful for making oatmeal. In most survival situations, especially in the winter time, it's important to drink a lot of alcohol because later on, it's recycled in your bladder.
Oh yeah. That's the stuff.
And you can pee it out and use it as fuel for building fires. I just recently peed on this toilet paper roll. Yeah, it should light pretty nicely there. Got ourselves a nice little fire. Now it'll help us keep warm for a while. Start making some oatmeal. Normally when you're in the wild, you don't want to boil your water for sanitation reasons. You actually have a greater risk of disease that way. So in the wild, you only want to boil water in case of making food. In this case, we are making oatmeal. I'm going to put it right over the little roll there. Get a nice little bubble going. So, you told me that early on about the deers. Were you in the deer wars?
Oh, man. Was I ever. The deer wars were so bad. As you know, Mr. Stevenson, that deers are carnivores.
I do know that, yes, we have had experiences with them in the past.
Yeah, exactly. That reminds me of this one time when I was in this awesome battle, and there's like 30 deer surrounding my unit. There's only 5 of us with heavy machine guns, and I flew in with my chopper. And I shot upon them with miniguns and a bunch of freaking missiles. And the deers weren't affected. They're tough.
Yes, I know.
Yeah. And
is it true what they say that the only way to kill a deer is by shoving a grenade into its mouth?
That's the only way of killing them.
My God.
So that's why when we had the miniguns firing on them, just ricocheted off their fur. Until I landed and dropped off another 10 guys with hand grenades only, and they jumped on top of the deer and started shoving grenades in their mouths.
You're a brave soldier. Thank you for your service.
Oh, yeah. It was an awful time. We lost a lot of men. I lost at least 50 guys in my group. It was bad.
Goodness.
So bad, man. Well, I'm going out to go hunt some deer because we need some kind of protein. We gotta stay alive out here. So I got my trusty hand grenade and also got my knife down here. So the only way of killing these deer, I'm gonna get on its back, stab it in the neck, shove the grenade up its mouth, and blow it up. It's the only way of doing this right. So I'm getting in my ghillie suit so they don't see me coming.
Well, I left our cameraman. He said he's gonna go hunt some deer. I say good luck. You know, in our experiences with deer, they have been very bad. In the first season, I lost Theodore to a deer. There was no helping him. So I hope that our cameraman now, Sid, gets a deer for us so we can continue surviving. He left me his Beretta handgun. He says it's the only way to stop a Bigfoot in case one comes round. However, if a deer comes, I'm not sure if I can survive. I've got a few other things here. I've got this tampon. And with these, once the water's done boiling, you open it up and you insert it into the water. And it actually gives it more of a nutrients, if you will. It spices the water, so to speak. It makes it more sanitized. Because if you don't have tampons and you drink water plain, you're more susceptible to disease.
Just to let you all know out there, in the military, they always give us butt calls. It's mandatory now, just because of the deer wars. So I will use this to attract one of the deers, so I can blow it up and eat it for nutrients. So, let me suit up.
Did you hear that? It sounds like a Bigfoot.
Oh man, my crotch itches. Oh, this'll work. There.
Oh my god, there it is. Oh, there it is. It's a real Bigfoot. It's making its mating call too. That's what the Bigfoots sound like. Alright, we need to take action. Bigfoot, all right. It's a Bigfoot. It's a massive Bigfoot. I'm gonna shoot this gun right at the Bigfoot's genitals. That's the only way to kill a Bigfoot.
Thank you.
got it. We got him. Oh, that's a big Bigfoot, all right. Look at the size of it. Let's remove the fur from the face. Oh my goodness. This is a rare deformity in Bigfoot. They have the power to change shape, often called shapeshifters in the natural world. He must have seen him earlier and took on his shape.
It's getting awfully cold here tonight. Helicopter pilot never came back from deer hunting. And I just had that close encounter with Bigfoot. Tonight's gonna be a rough night.
Say, kids, if you've ever tried tampons.
Oh, that was good.
Man, the freaking A. Is that the retake?
It was a real Bigfoot. He was scratching his balls.
Oh, no! It's a human!
Hello, my name is Guy Stevenson, and I'm completely sober right now. We just got after the bear.
You don't know what it says anymore, dingleberries.
Oh yeah, it took on his shape.
I thought you were going to take over, Stevenson, because you said I could take a nap on the helicopter, and you were fine flying the plane.
I thought we were driving the helicopter, not a plane.
In fact, during the Bigfoot mating season, in order to attract a mate, they must have clean genitals.
Go.
They must have clean genitals, so in order to clean themselves, they take these brush hairs, and then wiggle them on the genitals. So in order to keep up clean hygiene, Bigfoot uses these brushes to brush their bodies and the genitals. Then they get clean mates! Clean! I think it's only proper that we start making our fuel. Piss out our fuel. I'm not completely sober yet.
Yeah, I'll do that on the grill. Like,
where
my head is. Okay, I think I'm good now.
Alright.
Are we rolling?
Yeah.
Come on.
All in all, Siberia was a successful mission.